Hello and welcome back to your own channel, Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector. In modern era of air superiority fight, it's highly likely that beyond visual range fight may turn into a dogfight. Though there are many BVR missiles developed with longer range, 100 plus kilometers. However, their range and no-scope or kill zone also depends on attitude, speed and direction of fire. There are many countermeasures and maneuvers which has evolved that can exhaust missiles' energy and dodge them. That brings the fight to within visual range, WVR, that is somewhere in the range of 25 to 30 kilometers, where it's all about maneuverability and capability to perform high G turns. Therefore, in WVR, the ability to strike first becomes vital. Pilot needs a missile that can react rapidly with speed and maneuverability to maximize the kill probability regardless of EVC maneuvers and countermeasures deployed by the opponent. Talking about Tejas, it is not just a fighter jet but has been designed as a weapon delivery platform from day one. With its versatile weapon package, the fighter is going to be a formidable opponent in air against any Pakistani or Chinese fighter jet. Today's update is going to be related to within visual range or WVR air-to-air missile of Tejas. At present, the fighter jet is already integrated with Russian Wimpel R-73 and Israeli Python 5. Now there are updates coming related to British MBDA's ASR-AAM missile, which is the best missile at present in its class. The ASR-AAM missile will be integrated with Tejas by next year, and with this, Tejas will have three WVR missiles that it can fire. It can carry two such missiles with itself. As we all know that MBDA, which is Europe's leading missile manufacturer, has signed an agreement with Bharat Dynamics Limited, BDL of India, for the final assembly, integration and test of Mistral and ASR-AAM missiles in India. This will greatly improve the logistics and the maintenance of ASR-AAM missiles, which is going to be the main within visual range missile of Indian Air Force fighter jets. It will reduce the cost per missile due to its local assembly. However, there is no TOT for this missile, and for obvious reasons. MBDA cannot transfer the missile technology developed over decades and being one of the best in the globe. ASR-AAM weighs 88 kg and has a length of 2.9 meter and diameter of 166 mm. It has a range excess of 25 kilometers. The ASR-AAM can be launched in lock-on before launch or lock-on after launch modes. It has speeds over Mach 3 and can perform maneuvers of up to 50 G, which outperforms all existing short-range close combat missiles. The maximum G-turn that can be achieved by a fighter jet is of 12 G, which means the fighter jets cannot dodge ASR-AAM with its EVC maneuvers. The ASR-AAM offers 360-degree engagement coverage. The high G-turn gives the missile advantage to be launched in general direction of enemy, including at high angles, such as an over-the-shoulder shoot at a target behind the launch aircraft. The missile is then guided to the right direction using inertial guidance system, and then with the help of infrared focal plane array, the missile identifies the fighter jet. The infrared focal plane array is nothing but an advanced digital camera that acts as an eye for the missile. It is linked to the computer, which identifies the target by its shapes and guides the missile towards it, which makes the missile highly resistant to soft countermeasures. The missile integrates a highly lethal blast fragmentation warhead with impact and laser proximity fuses. The low signature rocket motor fitted in the missile enables high speed throughout the flight, while the guidance system ensures the engagement of targets in highly cluttered and countermeasures environments. The MBDA's SRAM is also known as AIM-132 in US. The SRAM missile will be integrated with Indian Air Force fighters such as Jaguar, Tejas, Su-30 MKI and MiG-29K, boosting their WVR combat capabilities. The Air Force of China and Pakistan does not have an answer to MBDS SRAM missile at present. Apart from SRAM, indigenous Astra MK1 integration is also progressing with Tejas and is expected to complete by next year. Astra will be a BVR missile. At present, Tejas can fire Israeli IRB and its ER version with range between 50 to 100 km. This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.